Now, if you've ever used variables before, if you're a programmer or a scripter, feel free to skip this section. This is an introduction to variables for those of you who may not have used it. Many designers, many artists, those of you looking to use the power of Playmaker and really leverage it without having to do a lot of programming might not be familiar with variables. And there's no shame in that, really. They're an amazingly powerful thing. You've been using them without realizing it in all kinds of software and games. So I'm going to tell you what they are on a really quick overview. And then all the examples we're going to do from here on out are going to rely on them really, really heavily. Because believe me, you can't get very far, very complex, or very fun in a game without really leveraging variables to a large degree. And don't worry, you don't have to do a lot of math. There's no crazy programming or advanced number crunching or anything like that. Playmaker makes things very easy and very quick to just use some menus and some quick drag togethers like we've been doing in the States, and you can really take full advantage of some really powerful variables. So what is a variable? A really simple way to talk about it is think of a bucket. You're holding a regular old bucket. You can put something in it, fill it up with that thing, you can look at what's inside of your bucket, and you can take things back out of your bucket. Say you had an apple in a bucket. You've got an empty bucket, right? And then you put the apple inside of it, and you could at this point say, I have a bucket with one apple in it. You could look in that bucket. What's in your bucket? Well, there's one apple. Look. And you could take that apple back out of your bucket at any time. Whatever is inside of a variable is called a value. And in this instance, the bucket is the variable, and the apple is the value. So when the bucket's empty, you could say the bucket equals empty. The value is empty. If you put the apple in the bucket, well, bucket equals one apple. If you had a second apple and you placed that inside of the bucket, your bucket would now be equal to two apples. See, pretty easy, really. If somebody came along and looked in your bucket, what's in your bucket? You could show it to them and they would say, ah, your bucket equals two apples. Anybody can look at and read that stuff. Anybody within your program, of course. Now that person might take an apple out and then you would have a bucket that equals one apple again. So variables and values, very simple concept, but they can be applied to anything. It's not just apples and buckets, of course. Let's hope not, or our games are going to be pretty lame. A variable, often you'll see storing numbers, the score of your game, the player's score, that would be a variable. Every time the player earns points or loses points, you add or remove it from that variable, and then somewhere on your HUD, you display the contents of that variable. That's like looking in the bucket to see how many apples are there. The HUD is just looking into the score variable to see what its current value is. Health is another way you'd use numbers to store the current state of something. The health value could be, say, start at 100 and go down to 0. You can check it at any point along the way. You can add value into the health variable by, say, picking up a health pickup. You can remove it by taking damage. Locations are another good example of a numerical value stored in a variable. Like, where is my player standing when he saves? Or where shall I teleport this character when she selects teleport? These are numerical locations, and you need to save those as variables so you can use them in all kinds of places. Not just numbers, though. You could also use a variable that stored an object. For example, you could save the next enemy to spawn as a variable, and the value could be the next monster that you're gonna spawn in for the player. A skeleton, a zombie, a wraith, or whatever it is. It could be the last thing that the player picked up. Did the player get the key, right? Did the player last touch a shovel? Did the player last touch a gem? Whatever it is. Playmaker supports a whole wide range of variables, pretty much anything you're going to need to do. And again, it makes it so powerful and quick and easy to just use a few key clicks, and you're going to get right at the power of all these variables and be able to use them. So let's go ahead and start working on more things and add in variables to make things even cooler.